Try off the heel. There come the Aggies. Another three. Wilkins, the fifth three for New Mexico State. Wow. 5 of 8 from beyond the arc.
Wilkins was just 7 of 23 from downtown last season. Shot that with no hesitation.
Neal probing. Last touching New Mexico State on the bounce.
And what happens sometimes is that you get sped up here when you're St. Mary's, but they're just a good closeout as well. But for New Mexico State, this has been a very strong showing thus far. And you can see the offense impacting their defense, Dave.
Nahr, leaner off the mark. This is A.J. Harris, transfer from Ohio State. Was in the concussion protocol a week before the first exhibition game. Mario Jones. Shot clock at 15. Red hot start for the Aggies, and that's a foul on Krebs.
Yeah, it's the rhythm, speed, balance, and quickness being emphasized this season. It's emphasized every season by the officials. But what happens frequently is coaches will say, we don't want our offense to affect our defense. But really what's happened tonight is that New Mexico State's defense has picked up. They're doing a better job of containing the ball, fewer straight line drives, because their offense has buoyed them here early, making threes. They've garnered confidence via their offensive prowess, and it's carrying over defensively.
And what about bringing in Jock Landale with his 2 fouls?
Well, you know, you gotta trust them.
Jock nearly got his third, reappearing on the other side. What a finish by Nadir.
That's a great example right there, Dave, of Landale having to play intelligently, defending without fouling, but Indier making the Gales pay.
Landale wants on the post, single coverage, backing in. Strong to the goal. Saved by Chua. Nice job of holding the ground defensively. Good ball movement. Hadley, free himself with the bounce, go baseline. Aggies with a little bit of a rhythm right now as Harris drains the three and Randy Bennett wants a timeout.
Well, there you go. When you're making threes and the opposition is making twos, you're in good shape. Look at the hustle. Endier. using the glass and the rim as a protector. Great passing here. Hadley finding Harris open. The ball moving through multiple quadrants. Harris and the Aggies oozing confidence. +8. With just under 9 to go on the road and the number 22 team in the country.
This program has been the gold standard in the WAC for many years. This year, Grand Canyon expected to give the Aggies a run. Bakersfield has been very good the last few years, and also Utah Valley.
Yeah, and you know, they're in that change. Coach Chance telling us that this is not the way it was done under Marvin Menzies. That worked. It worked with Paul Weir. But he's a new guy doing it his own way. New pieces. You know, they've lost the WAC Player of the Year 2 years consecutively in Siakam and then Baker. But don't forget, Hutchins transfers to Fresno State. That's 14 points a game they lost.
Evan Fissner attacks the goal. They on the drought. Cut the lead to 6.
Good response after timeout play by St. Mary's with poise, and they convert. And St. Mary's has been sped up here, Dave, by New Mexico State's defense. That was a good possession for the Gales.
St. Mary's a year ago, second in the country in scoring defense. This is Chua. Crooks the jumper off the mark. Landale with the rebound. Jordan Ford, the sophomore from Folsom, back on the floor. Throws up the runner. Four-year starter for Mike Wall with the Folsom Bulldogs.
Yeah, that's a gorgeous move. Those shots are really made during the off-season individual workouts. Great floater by Ford.
Aggies by 4. Jones. Fouled by Fitzner. He'll shoot 2.
Now what happens here, man-to-man defense. Nice post feed, up fade, going to the free throw line.
7:47 to play in the opening half. The Aggies giving the Gales all they can handle.
Downtown, as you alluded to, 67%, 61% overall, so that'll be a major point of concern for the Gales.
Jamario Jones, last year's WAC newcomer of the year, the foul shooter. The 5 for St. Mary's, Jordan Ford, Emma Nahr, Calvin Hermanson, Jock Landale, and Evan Fitzman.
Now, Jones averaged just about a double-double last season. You're on the road. You're up by 5. Guess what? His first points of the game. He has not really started to get going yet. So for New Mexico State, you feel like it's just a matter of time. Question of not if, but when he will contribute.
Jordan Ford wanting to ram it down low to Landale. Timer at 10. Eminar keeps the shot clock. Here's the ball screen. Evan Fitzner steps into a rainbow 3.
So well executed. Jones committed to helping. Wide open 3-pointer. Great conversion.
Evan Fitzner drives a 3. And they're getting into it here in Moraga.
You see Nahr again with the penetration. Look at Jones, how deep he helped. And Fitzner, you can't give him that kind of room. Another quintessential St. Mary's big man. Not only are they willing and excellent passers, they've got back-to-the-basket moves, but they can also play the perimeter game and shoot it.
This is the starting 5 for New Mexico State. Jones attack the goal. Create the contact and lay it in.
Jones with excellent recognition there. He saw space and was able to get there. If you see daylight to the stanchion, guess what? New Mexico State is going to penetrate. Excellent move and great decision making.
Jones only with 3. This is Jordan Ford, jump pass. Lob for Fitzner. Shot clock at 10. Evan tripped in a foul. That's on Lofton.
Fitzner trying to create there. To his credit, probably not his game, but he draws the foul.
That's Lofton's second foul.
When you think about these teams, Dave, in the NCAA tournament, of course, St. Mary's beating VCU, losing to Arizona. New Mexico State lost to Baylor, but they were up two at the half. And again, many new pieces for New Mexico State, but there's a culture and a energy and a vision of success. And no surprise they've come here to play.
Four out and one in. This is Jock Landale with the jump hook.
Excellent move by Landale. When he, again, Dave, when he receives so deep, he's going to make the pass.
This is Garza dropping inside. Jump hook by Wilkins off the mark. Tempo quickening on McCune. Close out on Fitzner. Dropping inside. Landale. Can't finish in the foul. Jock will shoot two. Nice find by Evan.
It really was. Now, Envia rotates here. And he's slightly late. He thought he had all ball. But again, this is what St. Mary's does to you. They make you work defensively. Now, the foul could have been on Jones. But we're back to, in a way, just having difficulty staying in front of St. Mary's, whether it's pick and roll or just good ball movement, player movement, put stress on the defense. And really, Coach Stans is probably pretty pleased with his defense. He lamented where they were at when we spoke with him pregame. They've done a pretty decent job against St. Mary's.
Well, Randy Bennett rolled the dice, putting Jock back on the floor with his two fouls. Made it pay off in a big way. Landale with 8 points in 14 minutes. We're tied at 32. Johnny McCann's on the floor for the first time for New Mexico State. Swarming on the post. And Evan Fisker can't believe it. Cora Shields with the whistle. Both teams with six fouls. Harris to squeeze the trigger, intersection of the base and lane line right. Step back, corner three. What a half for New Mexico State. 7 of 10 from three-point range.
You're gonna travel well when you shoot it like that from downtown. Tremendous baseline out-of-bounds play executed. Harris with a great Twitter handle, at famous_Amos12. That's the best one I've seen all day, Dave.
Now he's in there defensively. Hunter with a jump hook off the mark and a foul. Chris Jans liking the way his team is defending in the half court. That one charged to Jonathan Wilkins.
Pretty good post defense by Wilkins, but sometimes no good deed goes unpunished. Hunter will go to the line, another Australian recruit for the Gales. Of course, that pipeline well documented. Perhaps most notably by Patty Mills, Villanova.
All started with a guard named Adam Capehorn when Randy Bennett first got here, a backup guard that was being recruited as a D2 player. So you know what, I have a guy that I think you might like. Big guy, pretty skilled. Then Daniel Kickard became the all-time leading scorer at St. Mary's.
That's the beauty of college hoops. Guys develop, gain confidence.
McCants entry pass. Drop it inside. Chua get the finish. Rebound Hunter. St. Mary's down one with the basketball. Emmett Nahr changes directions, attacks the goal, and the Gales lead by one. What a half for Emmett. Nahr with 11.
Tremendous move by Nahr, well defended by Harris as well. So crafty is Nahr around the hoop. How does he get it done, David, 6-1? Harris probably goes 5'10", but still.
Chua, single coverage in the post. Can't get the jump hook and a foul. It's on New Mexico State's Eli Chua coming over the top.
See, great screen by Hunter. Nahr uses it. He gets in deep. Capitalizes yet again. No help, leaving Harris as a single primary defender. And now St. Mary's will have the opportunity to perhaps extend before the under four media break at the free throw line.
Jordan, 6 points, 3 boards in the opener against St. Francis. This is the front end of the 1-1. Garza, 4 out and 1 in. Eli Chua, single coverage on the post, backing in. Timer at 15. McCants does not want the three. Eli Chua wants the jump hook. Doesn't get the roll. Rebound, Tanner Cripps.
St. Mary's is doing a nice job, Dave, of getting multiple stops here. You hear coaches talk about a turkey 3 in a row. They want 4 in a row, 5 in a row. They've done a terrific job here of cooling New Mexico State over the last few minutes. Now with a precarious 1-point lead.
Evan Fitzner, shot deflected, taken by McCants. 3:20 to play in the half. New Mexico State down 1 with the basketball. A 3 for Harris. Grabs at the board. 2-on-2. Tanner lost the handle. Great hustle by the Aggies. Wide open. Hermanson for 3. Tap by Fitzner, foul on the inside. Ken Giddy with the whistle. We've got a good one in Moraga. 3:06 to play in the opening half. St. Mary's leads New Mexico State by 1. Bednar probing middle. This time they shut him off. Good closeout on Krebs. And foul on Jones. DeMario says, who, me? Cora Shields says, yeah, you.
Yeah, so it's rhythm, speed, balance, quickness. And here's Neal with a terrific finish. The son of the coach. Greg Neal was a great player for Bobby Krebs back in the day at Georgia Tech. He coached in the NBA under Lenny Wilkins with the Raptors. Rough go with it for Neal in New Mexico. Had some bright spots. But very difficult scenario playing for his dad there under the microscope in New Mexico. Good look at Krebs at the free throw line.
7, Fischer going to the bench. Jock Perry making his first appearance.
It's a real positive sign for St. Mary's to have a guy like Neal with so much experience and smarts coming off the bench as he is. Joe Rahan, of course, moving on. How do you fill that gap? Jordan Ford, Neal, terrific perimeter players.
2 Big Ten leaders off last year's team. Dane Pinot and Joe Rahan gone. Miller pass inside. Nicely done. That's McCants.
New Mexico State has done a nice job offensively. We've seen them in transition, a couple of good half-court possessions here. They're having no problem getting the ball into the paint. St. Mary's may make adjustments. Double more on the pick and rolls, perhaps fronting the post in the second half.
Tanner Krebs, step back three. Really came out at the end of last season and was a factor for the team in the postseason. That played very well at 12 against VCU in the NCAA tournament.
Yeah, this is a great job there by Krebs. Catch and shoot.
Final 5 seconds of the half. This is Harris. Rainbow three comes off the mark. Rebound Hermanson. And that will end the half. But New Mexico State has St. Mary's bobbing and weaving in the first half, but the Gales making a charge, rolling the dice with Landale back in the game that turned.
A great feed.
And Menard, huge first half, dropping inside to Landale. Picked up 2 early fouls. A jump hook in the chest of Chua and a foul on Eli.
Dave, I don't know if it's November or February. I'm already losing my voice. I feel like a coach.
Great atmosphere for the second game of the season.
Yeah, and this is what you've come to expect, of course. This is the norm at St. Mary's. This is not an anomaly, an aberration. The great fan support, the West Coast Conference, one of the best in the country, giving fans on the East Coast all kinds of sleeping problems, but to the great delectation, to the delight of the St. Mary's faithful,
nine
the Gales
straight,
are back in action.
9 straight 20-win seasons. They are the favorite to win the West Coast Conference this year. 4-point spread. Drop it inside to Chua. Eli lost the handle. Good ball movement. Lofted. Rainbow three. Left it short. Jones. The right hand finish. Remember, he had 19 rebounds in the season opener.
First second chance points for New Mexico State. First offensive rebound for the Aggies thus far tonight.
Landale sets the screen. Single coverage. Landale on the repost. Timer inside of seven. Way too deep, left it short. Landale taps. Taken by Nadir. Fitzner reaches in the foul. Foul on Fitzner, that is his third.
Now we know point of emphasis is always rhythm, speed, balance, and quickness. And one of the great mantras in the game is defend without fouling. So again, defensively, both teams, both coaching staffs will reinforce that mantra because you do not want to have your opponent in the penalty.
Eli Chua slipping free baseline around Landale. Tied at 48. Tanner Krebs back on the floor as Fitzman goes to the bench.
Excellent response by New Mexico State early here in the second half.
Chuck Landale in way too deep. Rattled off the jump hook. Chua lost the handle and out of bounds.
Now, with Landale, you've got to make a decision. We said it before. He's nominated for everything. He's like Drake and Eminem at the MTV Europe Awards. Now, you see New Mexico State here clearly letting him go one-on-one to operate without any help. It's a pick-your-poison decision.
With St. Mary's, so many weapons, when you pick your poison, it's the strict nine or the lie. Posting down to Landale, and it's a foul on Chua. Yeah.
And also, physicality in the post, another point of emphasis for this season, officiating-wise. Here's where St. Mary's is so tough, Dave, too. They wear you down, they break you down. Baseline out of bounds, they're so tough.
And McNarr, corner three. Right on cue. 16 for the senior from Australia.
Who's the most dangerous person in the gym? The inbounder. The inbounder is. We know that.
Gales by three.
How about Emmett Narr? He's playing at a very high level, Dave. He plays like you do play-by-play.
Land on the closeout. The ball came loose. This is Jordan Ford. St. Mary's leads by three. Making me blush. This is Ford, dropping inside, Landale, Jack and one, and bring the Aussie to the line for a chance at three. They love it at McCune.
Beautiful two-man game. The maturation of Jordan Ford out of Folsom High School, first start. The victory over St. Francis, PA, out of the Northeast Conference. And you know, Dave, now for Coach Jans, 5-point deficit, could be six. How does this possession go? You'd like to get to the under 16 media timeout here. St. Mary's, of course, it's a game of runs, creating them, sustaining them, overcoming them. Will the Gales make a run? Will the Aggies respond here?
Chalk now 3 of 6 from the foul line. Jordan Ford digging in defensively. Timer at 10. This is Lofton, crossover dribble. Step back from the foul line, left it short. Rebound Jones, fresh shot clock. Nadir, attack the goal. And finish with the left hand.
What made it happen? Again, another offensive rebound. They did not occur in the first half for Mexico State. They're happening now. Jones, remember, 19 and 19 the other night. Opening night blowout by New Mexico State. He's starting to awaken here.
Shot clock at 10. Calvin Hermanson rises up from the foul line. 10.
Wilkins in a tough decision there. He falls off of Hermanson to protect the basket. What happens? Hermanson's open. He was 9 for 9 to start the other night in the win over St. Francis. That's his game. And that's why St. Mary's is so tough to defend, as Chris Jans told Kate Rooney. That's why.
Wilkins off the mark with a jump hook. Gales lead by 5 with the basketball. Double down on Landale and a kick. There's our media timeout. That's 16 minutes remaining in the second half. 5 points run at the half. Gales still lead by 5. We've got a good one in Morongo.
The 4 for Nadir. And now, interestingly enough, Dave, the three-point differential plus 9 for New Mexico State, but they have not made a three. They've only made one over the last 11 minutes of play, but they're hanging tough here against St. Mary's on the rope.
Nahr, Ford, Hermanson, Krebs, and Landale for St. Mary's. This is Emmett Nahr, who has 18 points to lead all scorers.
Emmett Nahr, a provocateur, with Landale, a conundrum. Again, Wilkins hung out to dry. Do I finish, close out on Nahr? If not, Landale will finish. Just great decision-making on that pick and roll.
After trailing by as many as 8, the Gales lead by 7.
We talked, Dave, about it being a game of runs. Will St. Mary's extend?
Jard 3, Jordan 4 with a steal. The Gales have really clamped down defensively. It's a foul down low.
Now, when we talk to Coach Jans, talked about having to play a near-perfect game to win here. Ford, very opportunistic. Fertile Jordan Ford out of Folsom High School. St. Mary's has made 4 of their last 4 field goal attempts. Watch Nahr again here, Dave, for a 3. That will be. They ran the same play here, well defended that time by New Mexico State.
Isolate Jock Landale from the baseline. Really has diversified his game.
He's so solid. Got the mid-range game, back to the basket, the passing ability. St. Mary's is feeling it right now, Dave. New Mexico State needs a good offensive possession. They know this is the 22nd ranked team in the country.
That's a walk. Picking up that pivot foot.
You see Landale here cogitating, pondering. Because you know what? The stop and pop, well defended by Wilkins, but good offense beating good defense.
The preseason favorite in the West Coast Conference against one of the favorites in the WAC this year. Jock Landale got in too deep. This is lofted in for New Mexico State. Back double pump, lean or no, would have counted a shoot too.
Now when you look around the floor right now, tremendous matchup. You've got Lofton and Hermanson. You've got Nahr and famous Amos Harris. Not to mention Landale and Wilkins, right? And go on and on. So we said at the half, who will make the defensive adjustments? And these free throws are key. Anytime you reach kind of a drought scenario, particularly on the road, get to the basket, get to the free throw line. Cut the deficit to 7 with the clock stopped, of course.
Zach Lofton with 14 at 25 in the season opener. Cut the lead to 7.
Notice how the ball moves. Great ball movement. Side to side. Multiple quadrants.
Jordan Ford. Corner 3. And the Gales bench loves it.
It looks simple, but it stresses the defense. When the ball moves to multiple quadrants, good things happen. And that time it happened for 4.
Lofton step back jumper. Rebound Jones inside. Tough jump hook over Hermanson.
Jones is really getting after it on the offensive glass in particular. Plays with a high energy. Doesn't like drills in practice that are non-competitive. Showing that grit and determination here tonight.
Nahr, much more offensive-minded tonight. Offensive rebound, Landale. He can't finish, and Jock will shoot 2.
And Dave, you mentioned it. It was a critical juncture in the first half where Landale had 2 fouls. But here it is. Now, great job by our crew, as always. Landale on the post, inside out, finding Ford. Before that, we had multiple touches on the other side of the floor. 4 assists as well for Landale. And this is why the coaching staff at New Mexico State says, hey, St. Mary's is a handful to guard. And under the tutelage of Randy Bennett, he'll be around for another 10 years. He's on a 10-year deal, Dave. I'm game to game. I'm almost media break to media break. This guy's around for another decade. 2027, Randy Bennett. getting it done.
Now in Moraga. Year 17, he completely turned his program around. When he got here, they were 2-27.
It's amazing, really. It's one of the great stories in college basketball right here in Moraga.
Tua, three in the face of Landale. Randy Vinicius, you got to close out and get there quicker.
Good basket by Tua.
Cullen Neal will be in next time as dead for St. Mary's.
The second team all whack guy, Tua, did. A lot of talent on both squads.
Emmett Nahr with a runner. Stays with it in traffic. Silk Coy is down low. Calvin Hermanson. Baseline attack.
Yeah. We mentioned it earlier. Hermanson made his first nine shots. Guys around the team, they didn't even realize it. And that's a compliment, how good Hermanson is. That's not something out of his character. He just does it in a very quiet way.
New Mexico State takes a timeout, 12:25 to play in the half.
Good packages. Dave?
By the looks here, that is a hot ticket.
Absolutely. Absolutely, Dave. Let's take a look at the numbers. And again, St. Mary's up 8. Shooting 64% in the second half for the Gales.
And 57 for the game.
A lot of offense, Dave, as you mentioned earlier.
8-point spread. This is Lofton. Cut off with the pass by Hermanson. Timer inside of 5. The Gales defense really clamping down in the second half. What a split. Tough runner on the way. Spins off. Rebound loose inside. Jones after it. Taken by Tua with a corkscrew flip on the inside.
That's been an adjustment by New Mexico State. They're attacking the offensive glass. 0 offensive rebounds during the first 20 minutes. 0 second chance points. Another opportunity there seized by the Aggies.
Aggies plus 1 on the boards tonight. Single coverage.
And those opportunities limited, Dave, due to the high shooting percentages by both squads.
John Landale with a left-handed finish. Remember last year, Dane Pineau was going to be the starter in the middle. When Dane had a bad back, that gave Jock his chance.
He has certainly capitalized on it.
Aggies turnover. To the chagrin, Chris Jans.
Now, the Aggies feeling it. Up by 8, extending on the back of Landale. During the timeout.
Emmett Nahr with a runner, left it short. Pinball machine bounce. Controlled by Neal. And the first shot clock for the Gales. Leading by 8. Diagonal pass over the top. Good ball movement, Krebs. They spaced the floor so well in their half-court sets.
Yes. Space, pace, people movement, ball movement.
Neal off the mark on the 3. Jones with a rebound. Jamario attacked the goal. Shot deflected. Krebs with a great job defensively. This is Emmett Nahr. Got caught up in the air.
A little nonverbal communication here, Dave. High pick and roll.
Nahr tried to wrap the pass around, deflected by New Mexico State out of bounds. Evan Fitzner back on, replacing Tanner Krebs for the Gales.
St. Mary's now has 11 points off of turnovers, Dave. 6 of them by New Mexico State. At the half, it was only 4 points off of 2 New Mexico State turnovers. So St. Mary's playing opportunistically.
Calvin Hermanson would have counted for 3 in the foul. The foul on Nadir, who can't believe it, shaking his head in disgust.
Now you've got to let the jump shooter come down. Zadier trying to defend. Good effort. And we see a great screen by Landale. Another baseline out of bounds play. You know, you hear guys talk about the difference between the NBA and college basketball, and so many baseline out of bounds plays in college that are so difficult to defend. We've seen Nahr, right, as the inbounder floating to the corner with a little handoff, not even a dribble handoff. Randy Bennett spending his summers probably clandestinely in Santa Cruz behind a beach umbrella and sunglasses, drawing these plays up as the rest of the West Coast Conference tries to keep pace with the Gales. The only place more crowded, Dave, than this arena is the gift shop that Kate Rooney took a look at, the Holidays looming. I'd be a little worried about inventory right now. Don't worry, don't take care of it.
Red Hot program leading by 10. The pick to win the league ahead of Gonzaga and BYU this year. Trailing by as many as 8, leading by 10. This is Jones. Can't get Fitz to the bite. Rebound Landale. You know, the Aggies last year, Bill, 1.1, 20 consecutive games.
You mentioned it at the top, Dave, how much winning both of these programs have done.
Calvin Hermanson. Coming up a 24-point game. All-league player a year ago. New Mexico State needs a timeout. The Aggies looking to avoid losing contact here.
That's a great timeout by Jans. He had no choice but to take it. Blow to not rebuild this program. Excellent test for them. And for St. Mary's, you got to be pleased with the second half defense turning over the Aggies on your home floor.
Great measuring stick game for both sides. Wilkins on the post. Catches shoot three, Nadir. Left it short. Rebound Landale. One and done for New Mexico State.
Now, New Mexico State, Dave, again, they've only made 2 threes since the first 8 minutes of this game.
Love the way they compete. They're flying all over the floor. What an effort for Jan's team.
Yeah, I mean, Indier and Jones hitting the deck without hesitation. You see the good sportsmanship. He acknowledges Evan Fitzner. They exchange low fives there. You love to see that, the great competitive spirit and respect between the players on the floor. You know New Mexico State earned it immediately. And you mentioned just a couple of years ago, Dave, it was a 2-point St. Mary's win here on this floor, postseason style.
Evan Fitzner, step back three. 15-point spread, the largest of the game for the Gales.
They're 3 of 5, 2 of 2 from three.
How many times are you gonna miss?
Nadir missed a three and a foul.
And Fitzner really, Dave, is one of those guys that probably doesn't get enough attention. But you see Nahr here with the over-the-head pass back to Fitzner. A great read. You talk about space, pace, people, and body movement. What does Fitzner do on Nahr's penetration? You either pick, pop, or roll. He pops for an open three. Started 70 games as a junior. A steely, wily veteran all of a sudden was Fitzner.
Made 43% of his threes last year. 45 makes.
That's great dexterity to the offense.
Well, not three. Last touching St. Mary's, and out of bounds. From here, looked like it went off the knee of the New Mexico driver. Off Lofton's right knee.
Officiating's a tough job. Looked like it should have been St. Mary's ball, but we have the benefit of the instant replay of the officials, not at this juncture.
Split that double loft and attack the goal. Flip it up and run and count it. Bring Lofton to the line for a chance at three. Last year's SWAC Player of the Year for Texas Southern.
Just great athleticism. And also on the road, Lofton recognizing that New Mexico State needs to score to try to get back in this, bring it to single digits, perhaps before the under 8 media timeout. We've mentioned Texas Southern, the Tigers, who Gonzaga defeated the other night. A staple in the SWAC.
Lofton finishes off the three-point play. McCants in as Jones goes to the bench for New Mexico State.
And he's been battling a hip flexor, Lofton has, and showing no ill effects thus far tonight.
Randy Bennett takes a timeout. And the Aggies need to clamp down and turn up that defensive thermostat.
So now for nice spectacles inside McEwen. St. Mary's looking to extend, leading by a dozen, trying to make it a Baker's dozen and more, but the Aggies stand in the way.
Favorites in the West Coast Conference trailed New Mexico State by 8 in the first half, now lead by 12, 74-62. Dave Lewis, Bill Herenda, and Kate Rooney from the McCune Pavilion in Moraga. New Mexico State came out red hot from the three-point line. Since then, 1 for 5 in the second half. Have the Gaels defended them better, or are they simply missing open shots?
I think it's a combination of both, Dave. Frequently, you hear this about the NBA, it's a make-or-miss league, and certainly New Mexico State got St. Mary's attention in the first half. They are closing out better on threes, but make no mistake about it, there have been some good looks that the Aggies just have not converted on. And here we see full court pressure. No surprise here. Can they turn over St. Mary's? The Gaels, how many turnovers tonight? I had more cups of coffee than they've had turnovers, just 3. Impressive performance on their home floor.
Just 1 turnover in the second half. Cullen Neal back on the court for the Gaels, looking to negotiate the zone. Timer at 10. Jock Landale reappearing on the other side, can't finish. Evan Fitzner. They tie him up. This time the arrow points to St. Mary's. And that's what Randy Bennett wants from Fitzner, to be a better rebounder this year, to fill the void left by Dane Pinot.
Yeah, that would really round out Fitzner's game. Out of San Diego, 6'10", junior. He's part of the West Coast Conference All-Freshman team a couple of years ago. He's yet to miss a start in his career, Dave. He started 70 games. A staple of stability, durability, causing vulnerability to the opposition.
Evan Fitzner probing middle. Create the contact, can't finish. Pass touching Jock Landale and out of bounds.
So we'll see if Neal provides the same spark here in the second half that he did in the first half. He took that charge, 2 great drives to the basket, brought some good energy. Gaels now with a 12-point cushion, under 8 to go. They'd love to extend here, but Aggies can travel out here. Cannot get their money's worth.
What a move by Lofton. Off the mark with a 3, and Fitzner with the rebound. And Menar probing middle. Lift step through, finish, and 1, and bring Nar to the line for a chance of 3. He's got 20 to lead all scorers.
It's uncanny how he's got the ability to get into the paint. He's set up by the screen by Landale. And you know, what do? There, you fight over it, not a bad strategy. But without help, he's got the ability to finish. If you switch it, then you've got a big on a little. And conversely, you got a mouse in the house with a little guarding a big. So it's a conundrum. He's a provocateur. And it's really amazing to watch his creativity into the painted area.
Not as there at will. Not especially athletic, though, in terms of what you think of a guy being able to get to the basket and score using angles and uses his body really well.
You know, he's 6'1", but when you look at him, nice look here, too. This is a play similar to what Jans ran for New Mexico State to start the half that led to a bucket by Chua. He's back at the free throw line. But on Nard, Dave, when you look at him at 6'1", he's got very long arms, he's wiry, and he makes excellent decisions. He has a sixth sense of when to drive, when to pull up, knows when Landale is going to pick, pop, roll. Same with Fitzner. Here's the pressure now, 2-2-1 style by the Aggies.
Lead cut to 12.
Now Hadley's on the floor. He's a three-point threat. High hopes for him. Aggie staying in zone right now.
Jar three, Fitzner gets it back. Timer now at 7. Cullen Neal, drop it inside to Landale. So patient with the shot clock winding down.
You know, sometimes it's just basketball. New Mexico State was in a zone. What do? Penetrate, drive, and Landale rolls to the basket. Great decision by Neal. Easy conversion.
Lofton splits the ball screen and attack the goal on a right-handed finish.
Yeah, the Aggies are not going to—they're not going to go anywhere. They're going to hang tough here. Try to speed up St. Mary's. They did a good job of that in the first half, not resulting in turnovers, but just not very good possession for St. Mary's. But again, the other opponent slowly looming, like the gloaming that comes over St. Mary's with the standard daylight time, is the clock.
Cullen Neal off the mark at the three, reached the miss, gets his own, attack the goal, throw it up and in, and bring Cullen to the line for a chance at three. The transfer from Ole Miss in his final go-round here in Moraga.
He just follows his shot. And Hadley, as a young player, will learn that it's one thing to close out, but you also must hit, find, and go get it in the vernacular of Tom Izzo. And Cullen Neal now, after toiling for his father in New Mexico at Ole Miss, follows his shot and cashes it.
Neal averaged 9 points per game last year for Ole Miss in 12 starts. Evan Fessner goes to the bench. Tanner Krebs back on. 15-point spread.
And for Hadley, he's an Aussie as well, just a freshman. So it's part of the learning and maturation process. That's something that's very valuable on film when you sit down and break it down by the whack portion of the schedule. Hadley's boxing everybody out. He's boxing out on the team dinner online.
Eli Chua off the mark with a three. Landale clears the rebound. Inside of 5.5 to play in the second half. St. Mary's trailed by as many as 8 in control. It's a 15-point spread. Krebs, Neal, Hermanson, Nahr, and Landale for St. Mary's. This is Emmett Nahr with the floater. 22 for the senior.
Good help that time by Chua, but Nahr just hits a floater, drains it over.
Lofton can't finish. Hermanson boards. St. Mary's at 57% for the game. Making it so easy as Landale rips it home.
Well, just a busted assignment there by New Mexico State. And of course, St. Mary's capitalizes.
Jock with a primal scream. Too easy.
That's why, you know, you're building every day, every drill to get better, improve. The being in the moment, right? So important to performance.
This is Jones, big time competitor.
Yeah, he really is. He's hungry. Aggies know it to a man now that they've got to clamp down, turn over the Gales. Look at St. Mary's here on the offensive end to be selective, be smart, play intelligently. They know the clock is in their favor at this juncture.
Elijah Thomas on the floor for the first time. Made a couple threes in the season opener. Blocking foul. That's on Jones with Cullen Neal on the drive.
Now, it'll be interesting to see here if Jones was in the restricted area or not. Looks like he's a step late regardless. If he's in the restricted area, it's a block to begin with. But Neal has shown that propensity to penetrate and to drive. So that was a scenario where you thought maybe Neal would pull up because he kind of risked drawing a charge.
2012, Mr. Basketball in the state of New Mexico. Was originally going to be a Gale, had the chance to play for his father. He mentioned a difficult time. It wasn't so much playing for his father, it was everything around it with the fans. New Mexico wasn't as good as they'd been in the past, and Neal really was the object of the fans' displeasure.
And they were good early in Neal's career there. They made the NCAA tournament, but Alex Kirk was there. Cameron Bairstow from Australia. There were some terrific players. But and early they had success, Dave, but they weren't able to sustain it. So to his credit, he's persevered and moved on. New Mexico State's next game, by the way, will be against New Mexico. Huge rivalry, of course, game for both schools.
Loader by A.J. Harris, good for the Aggies.
Mike Brown's son, Elijah Brown, toiled at New Mexico as well, along with Cullen Neal.
And what about the Aggies getting to play against their former coach?
Yes, Paul Weir, exactly.
Three off the mark by Neal. Offensive rebound, Krebs, and a fresh shot clock. 3:20 to play second half. St. Mary's on top by 17. Looking to start off 2-0 for the second consecutive year. A rare turnover. Transition three off the mark by Harris. Rebound, Krebs. St. Mary's last year started off 6-0 before the loss to Texas Arlington. And that was really a wake-up call. And UTA turned out to be a very good basketball team.
Scott Cross is one of the best coaches in the country. No fluke whatsoever, Dave, you're right.
Emmett Nahr, kick out Krebs, catch and shoot three. Front rim backward and off. Two of swords for the rebound. And a foul on St. Mary's, Elijah Thomas. We'll take the timeout. 2:38 to play in the second half. The Gales and Randy Bennett can see the finish line. It's a 17-point lead. St. Mary's basketball is brought to you by an enthusiastic McCune Pavilion in Morocco. Good test for St. Mary's. One of the favorites to win the WAC. We spoke about Grand Canyon and Dan Marley this year. Old friend Oscar Freyer from Moreau Catholic on that team is starting forward. Also, Damari Milstead, a freshman guard.
There you go, Dave. Small world. The hoops world is.
At Moreau, they played for Frank Knight, a former Gale. There's a runner by Harris. Tough floater off the elbow.
Harris has got a solid game. Here's the pressure again. course, New Mexico State has got to pressure St. Mary's. But the Gaels handle it with great aplomb. With Neal on the floor. Nahr not on the floor right now, Dave. Neal and Ford in the backcourt.
Tanner Krebs. Timer inside of five. Jordan Ford, peak at the clock, throw up a runner with the right hand. Rattles out, rebound inside. Hunter, he can't finish. And soaring up high is Thomas. His team may go down tonight, but certainly he's given everything he can. That's a turnover along the baseline.
Well, Dave, if you look at the criteria for St. Mary's, their goals every night, turnovers 12 or less, they have four. Rebound margin plus six, they're plus five. Field goal percentage against 40% is the goal. 49 for New Mexico State. 41% from three is where New Mexico State is. 30% is the goal. So Coach Bennett will, yeah, he'll take the victory here, but looking at these numbers, he'll want to bring down that field goal percentage against overall and from three in a significant way.
Krebs takes a seat. Jock Perry back on the floor. Negotiating the 2-2-1 full court press. As we wind it down inside of 90 seconds to play second half. Following up the win over St. Francis. With an impressive second half and pulling away from New Mexico State. This is Neal for a corner three. 12 points off the bench for the fifth year senior.
He really gave St. Mary's a spark early, Dave. And again, we see good ball movement. New Mexico State late with the closeout. Neal capitalizes, all grins on the sidelines for the Gaels.
Tommy Cousy on the floor for the first time, a freshman from Mesa, Arizona. Final minute of play. Remember, St. Mary's trailed in this game by eight in the first half.
New Mexico State played well, particularly early. So many positives for Coach Jazz and his program here tonight. And for St. Mary's, we talked about New Mexico next for New Mexico State. Dedrick Taylor has done a fine job at Cal State Fullerton, so that'll be another non-conference test here for the Gaels. Got to bring it every night. You know everyone's going to bring it against St. Mary's. 22nd in the country.
This year, the Gaels take a trip to California on the 23rd of the month. Also playing the Quinn Legacy. First round game against Harvard. Also playing Dayton this year. Last year, had to travel to Dayton. Picked up a huge win on the road. Doc Landell taking the rest of the night off, along with Emmett Nahr and Evan Fitzner. Good night at the office.
Yeah, it really was good performance. And St. Mary's was tested here. There's no doubt about that. That's what you want. You want to find out, learn about your team.
Bill, John Perry played at the Basketball Australian Center of Excellence for Adam Capemorn, the first Aussie to play at St. Mary's.
Great lineage and pipeline. Moraga, home away from home. There's so many terrific Aussie players. What's up with that? Patty Mills and Matthew Dellavedova, perhaps the most recognizable names.
Back cut, a nice finish for Lester Gordon. His first points of the season. A scoreless in 2 minutes in the season opener. Jordan Ford will run it out. And Rennie Bennett puts the clipboard down. Has a 10-year deal and a 2-0 start. Pretty good challenge from the Aggies early on. St. Mary's drops the hammer in the second half and wins at 92-74.
Yeah, the second half, Dave, when you look at the numbers, St. Mary's tightened things up defensively and took care of business. But this was a very entertaining game, non-conference style, by two perennial programs that have had a lot of success within their own conferences.